Hello, my name is Lu Mengjing. I am a recent graduate who majored in illustration at Malaysian Institute of Art. I would like to share about my final semester work, a project about the phenomenon of night owls. We always heard about people saying staying up late tonight is harmful to our bodies. People refer to those who stay up late at night as night owl because of their nocturnal habits, which is the opposite of the early birds. As a youngsters and night owl, we all know about it but we just couldn't stop from doing it. I hope this project can raise some awareness about it. For this project, I've produced 5 pieces of illustrations, each from a different time period from the 1970s to 2010s, with character doing various activities at night. The character is mixed with the characteristics of human and owl. The structure of the body is inspired from the owls and is simplified to an egg-like shape. The nose is a smaller size of the beak and the head is a bit oval-shaped. Since the feather has various patterns, I shaded darker on the below of each hair strand. The character have puffy, tired-looked eyes and dark circles under the eyes. According to the research, most of the people were gaining weight as they eating in late night. So, I make them look chubbier with some belly fat and double or triple chin. The outfits and hairstyle changes according to the fashion trends in different time periods. The first illustration is set in 1970s. During that time, it's quite popular watching movies in movie theater. I chose one of the movie theater in Kuala Lumpur, which is Cathay Theater. People queue up just to buy tickets for movies. The billboard shows one of the popular movies in 70s. It's quite fun that every character having different hairstyles and outfits. This activity is kind of relieving our stress. Whenever a new movie come out, it became a special event day. Everyone would like to be the first one to watch it, and it's really fun when you immerse yourself into the movie. The second one is in 1980s. During the night, people would dress up and go for disco party to show off their moves. I tried to create the disco vibe by adding the neon lights and mirrored disco ball in the club. Many people will go to the club after work. It's like people who go clubbing and partying around nowadays. The passionate moves help them express themselves fully, even vent out their frustrations. No one will make any criticism. It's a place that provides freedom for them and let them escape from the reality once in a while. The next one is in the 1990s. As technology builds up, video game has entered our life. We usually playing the video game on cathode ray tube TV. Different electronics like DVD player, MP3, Game Boy are used for entertainment at home in those days. Some people will collect their favorite posters and decorate it in their room. I link it with the procrastinator type because people may put aside the important tasks and distract by doing other things. And normally they end up burning the midnight oil to complete the task. Sometimes, people really enjoy doing things at night when the others are asleep. Not everyone stay up late just for entertainment. Some people is because they are overload work. Some may have work 9 to 5 every day, but some have to work overtime or some start to work at night. I decided to use an office as a background in the early 2000s. The nightlife also started to fill with more lights. They always have a busy schedule and staying up late has become their habit. Last one is the current decade, 2010s. Many people started to use their phone even though they are lying on the bed. Some may even watching videos, checking social media, or playing online games before they sleep. K-pop also has a significant influence in Asia. People follow the fashion style started by the idols and collect the merchandise of their favorite idols. The messy room represents the personal freedom they want to achieve. People are having very tight schedule every day, even the student today. They lengthen their free time by sleeping late at night. Some say that is a way of revenge themselves and the society to earn more free time from feeling unfair. The stress levels are rising these days. Maybe it's a time to help them to cope with their stress. I can say that I'm actually experiencing the things in my illustrations. I need to draw all the details one by one. Before I do that, I research the things I need to add into the work, but I spend more and more time on it because I hardly find the right one. I never thought that the researching and the drawing process would take much more time than I expected. Maybe I'm too afraid. I always procrastinate. I admit that I'm a perfectionist too. This made my progress slower and slower. My sleep schedule on every day is different. Sometimes I sleep after the sunrise. When everyone fell asleep, I found that is the only time is peace and calm for me. I stay in hostel. When everyone off their lights, is the moment I became active. When this topic goes deeper, it can link to the mental health too. It's not just about the health for our body. For some people, the nighttime is when they can heal themselves. I hope people can think deeply and take it seriously. As the society evolves, something you think is very common, the insight maybe is far from your expectations. Thank you very much for hearing my experience and process of producing the work.